court reporter in this matter is Catherine Kaplanik. The deposition is being videotaped, and I would ask the persons responsible for the videotaping of this deposition to orally identify themselves for the record, please.
Betty Lamore of Thumbs Up Production, located at 6595 Creston Road in Paso Robles.
And assisting you, ma'am, is another individual. Could that individual identify themselves, or could you identify them, please?
Mark Lamore with Thumbs Up Productions.
And Mr. Coates is present. Cumberland Coates.
Greg Coates, present on behalf of Reuben Flores.
And it's my understanding, Mr. Coates, that you are an attorney retained by the Flores Homeowners Insurance Carrier Farmers to provide representation to Mr. Flores, and that you are here in that capacity, correct?
That's correct.
Would you please swear the witness?
Raise your right hand, please. You do solemnly swear the testimony you're about to give in this matter should be the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth to help you, God.
I do.
Thank you.
Mr. Flores, would you state your date of birth, please?
April 9th, 1941.
And where were you born?
Compton, California.
And, could you indicate for me where you have resided in general since the time of your birth?
Hermosa Beach, Redondo Beach, Torrance, Arroyo Grande.
Would it be fair to say that your family moved to Arroyo Grande sometime in the, was it the late 80s?
I think.
Okay. Can you give me a specific date upon which your family moved to the Arroyo Grande area?
June? I don't know what year.
Okay. When you moved to the Arroyo Grande area, what was your first residence address upon arrival in this area?
710 White Court.
And have you maintained a residence at that address since June of some year in the 1990s?
Yes.
And you presently reside at that location?
Yes.
When you moved here to the Arroyo Grande area, who accompanied you on that move?
A wife and two children.
And your wife's name?
Susan.
Middle name?
Paula.
And your children's name?
Paul.
And his middle name?
Reuben.
And your other child's name, please?
Ermelinda.
And her middle name?
Marie.
And where does Ermelinda Marie reside at this time?
Irvine.
And in May of 1996, where did Ermelinda reside?
When she was going to college, someplace by the college. I don't know what street it was.
Did you have occasion to visit her while she was residing near the Cal Poly campus?
Yes.
And do you recall the street upon which she resided?
No, I don't remember.
Was that a single family residence? Apartment or dorm?
Duplex.
And do you know the names of her roommates at the time? Do you know the name of her roommates, if any?
Yes, Brett MacArthur.
And Mr. MacArthur, do you know his present whereabouts?
Irvine.
And does Mr. MacArthur reside with Ermelinda?
Yes.
And what is the nature of their relationship, if you know?
Husband and wife.
Does Ermelinda use her husband's last name at
yep.
this time?
Yes.
Was she married to this gentleman in May of 1996?
No.
Do you know when they were married?
August 96.
And where was the wedding held?
On the gazebo in Shell Beach.
And do you know the date
Yes.
Your wife is Susan Flores. Are you still married?
Yes.
And does she reside with you at 710 White Court?
No.
Where does she presently reside?
529 East Branch.
And how long has she resided there? At 529 East Branch.
I don't know.
Can you give me an approximation or estimate as to the time that she moved to that location most recently?
No.
In the confusion of setting up this video big deposition, I apologize for not providing you with certain admonitions that I would like to advise you about, and then ask you at the conclusion of that if my failure to give you those admonitions has in any way affected the quality of your answers. I'm assuming that you've had an opportunity to speak with your attorney, Mr. Coates, in connection with this matter. Is that correct?
Yes.
And have you also had an opportunity to speak with Mr. Delamotte in connection with this matter?
No.
And I'm sure that your attorney gave you some generalized idea about what a deposition was, did he not?
Yes.
Have you had your deposition taken before in any matter?
No.
I know that Mr. Coates is an extremely thorough attorney, and I'm sure that he's told you what I'm about to tell you, but just to clarify the record, I want to advise you first that a deposition is a proceeding in a litigated matter at which a party is entitled to get the testimony of another individual, whether party or not, under oath. The lady sitting to your left is a court reporter who is empowered by California law to sit at these proceedings and prepare a transcript of what is said by all the parties in connection with this matter. The lady is writing down everything that is being said by anyone in this room, and at the conclusion of this process will prepare a booklet, which is a deposition transcript, which will contain hopefully the entirety of what is said here today. You will have an opportunity to review that booklet and check it for accuracy and make any changes to the testimony that you wish to make. I would advise you that if you make a material change in your testimony, that is, change something that is deemed important, that a lawyer at the trial of this matter will comment upon that, perhaps to your embarrassment and or discomfort. Do you understand that?
Yes.
Are you under the influence of any medication at this time which would preclude you from giving clear and accurate testimony here today?
No.
Have you consumed any alcoholic beverages in the last 24 hours?
Yes.
The amount of alcohol that you consumed is not my concern or business. I want to know whether or not the alcohol that you have consumed has in any way dulled your senses so as to make it more difficult for you to give accurate testimony.
No.
Deposition, I am entitled to your best estimate as to a matter. I do not want you to guess or speculate. Your attorney will advise you, if necessary, at certain points in time as to his desire to speak with you. If he wishes to speak with you, he can adjourn this proceeding temporarily at any time and take you to a place of privacy and speak with you concerning any matter. If you wish to take a break at any time, you are certainly permitted to do so. If you would simply indicate to me that you wish to take a break, I will immediately accede to your wishes and permit you to leave this room, consult with your attorney, get a drink of water, get some fresh air, whatever you wish to do. As far as the issue of estimate versus guess, I want estimates if I can obtain them from you. I do not want guesses. I do not want speculation. Lawyers often use the following analogy to show the difference between an estimate and a guess. If I ask you to estimate the size of the table at which we are sitting, as you're looking at this table, you could probably give me an estimate. If I ask you to estimate the size of the table in my dining room at my residence, where you have never been, you would simply have to guess. Mr. Coates, I'm not the world's greatest attorney at giving admonitions, and I would certainly invite you at this point in time to add anything you would wish to the record so that we do have a fair proceeding here today.
I think you covered it.
Now, I had asked you some questions, sir, about where you lived and when you moved and who your family members were. Any of those questions that I asked you that you would like to change the answers based upon the admonition? Have you been a defendant in any lawsuit?
I was a defendant.
Have you been sued in a civil lawsuit by any individual in your adult life?
No.
Have you been sued as the guardian or parent of Paul Flores, your son, as a result of any allegation of misconduct by any individual against your son?
If I've been sued, that's a question? Because of this?
No, sir.
Okay.
You understand that you are not a defendant in the suit that the Smart family has brought against your son, correct? You are not being personally sued?
No.
You understand that your son is being sued?
Yes.
In the past, prior to the commencement of this lawsuit, to your knowledge, has your son been sued for any act of misconduct or allegation of misconduct by him?
There was a settlement, but I don't understand it.
Right. I'd like to ask you some questions about the settlement. Were you involved in the, was your son a minor at the time that a person made a claim against him for damages in a civil action?
What civil action is this?
I apologize if I'm using lawyer talk, and it's not meant in any way to be disrespectful to you, so if I'm not communicating my questions properly, I apologize and I'll start over. There was a settlement in a case that involved your son, correct?
I'm not sure when you use the word case or claim. Claim might be more accurate.
Okay. Well, can you put the horse in front of the wagon and start telling me what claim and what action before we get to going backwards, because I don't understand what claims are, I don't understand what judgments are, I don't understand what anything is.
Okay, you used the word settlement. And settlements suggest to me that somebody paid some money to someone else. Is that your understanding of what a settlement is?
Yes.
And is it your understanding that someone paid some money to somebody else because of something your son was alleged to have done?
I'm not sure. I believe there was a settlement, but I'm not sure.
Do you know the... what happened? Strike that. What is your understanding of what your son is alleged to have done to cause someone to pay a settlement on his behalf?
Where was this at?
Well, you had indicated that there was a settlement in a case.
But I don't understand. We're talking about the same thing. What are you talking about?
Okay. I want to know what your son did to make somebody pay money to somebody else.
But where was this at?
Well, was there more than one settlement?
The one you're speaking about is a settlement. Are you speaking about a specific settlement?
Yes.
And what settlement is this?
The settlement that you told me was paid.
I believe, I'm not sure. Well, okay. Can you be specific?
Sure. What was the name of your insurance company, if you know, that paid the settlement for something your son was supposed to have done?
Well, I've had farmers for 40 years, so I imagine it'd be farmers.
And were you living in Torrance at a time that your son got in a fight with another individual?
Oh, that's what you're talking about.
Yes.
Okay. Yes.
And what is it that your son was alleged to have done to this other person?
There were three persons.
Okay. Who were the three persons that were involved in this incident that we're generally talking about?
What's their names?
Yeah.
I don't know.
Did your son, was your son accused of inflicting injury on someone when you lived in Torrance, resulting in farmers paying some money to the person who got injured?
Yes.
Did your son injure one person? Or three persons?
I believe one.
You had said that something about there being three persons. What did you mean by that?
Three kids jumped on him at school.
So three kids jumped on your son at school.
Yes.
And then there was a fight, obviously, that occurred, correct?
Between four of them, my boy and three others.
And what were the injuries suffered by the person who received the money from farmers?
I don't know.
Did you talk to your son about the fight that occurred when three people jumped on your son and ultimately farmers paid some money to someone?
Yes.
Okay. What did your son tell you what occurred in this incident that led to farmers paying a claim?
Before you answer that, Reuben, let me just, for the record, object that it's not reasonably calculated to lead to the discovery of admissible evidence. I'll allow Mr. Flores to answer, and counsel, if you can give me a running objection as to this line of questions.
I appreciate your professionalism, Mr. Coates, and you do have a running objection. If I were to each time articulate the theory or theories that I believe make this relevant and reasonably likely to lead to admissible evidence, we'd be here just this witness all day today. So you certainly have it, and if you feel at any appropriate time that you want to reassert it, that's okay, but I'll give you a stand objection for that.
Thank you.
Probably the entirety of this deposition and the rest of them today. What did your son tell you happened in the fight?
He was walking on a playground, and three kids came and started harassing him and pushing him around, and he pushed back, and they grabbed him from the back, a couple of them, and he's pushing and shoving and trying to get away from them.
Did your son indicate to you that he had kicked a person in the head in that altercation?
He had kicked one. I don't know where he kicked him at. Well, one boy was holding him, and he's trying to get away. He's doing everything he can to try to get away, and one kid got hurt.
Right, and do you know if the kid that got hurt was hospitalized as a result of the injuries? Do you know the amount of the medical bills that were paid on behalf of the kid that got injured?
No, I don't.
Do you know the name of the kid who got injured?
No, I don't.
Do you know if a lawsuit was filed against your son?
No, I don't know.
Did your son... When we were talking about this, you and I were talking about this subject generally. I may have incorrectly formulated the idea that there might have been more than one incident in which your son was involved in some accusation or of violence towards another person. Was there more than one incident in which farmers paid a claim for injuries allegedly incurred by someone as a result of a fight with your son?
Did farmers pay somebody?
Right.
Not that I know of.
Have there been, during the course of the time that you have resided with your son, Paul Flores, have there been other occasions on which Paul has become involved in fights which have led to injuries to persons?
No. Okay. Go ahead. Objection not reasonably calculated to lead to the discovery of admissible evidence. You can go ahead and answer the question.
Not that I know of.
You are aware of the, I'm sure, of the nature of the lawsuit in this particular case, correct?
Not very well.
All right. Let me ask you a couple of questions about Susan Flores. On May 25th of 1996, where was Susan Flores living?
Night 26th?
25th of 1996, where was Susan Flores living?
Is that the Labor Day weekend or
yes.
Whatever they call it?
That was Memorial weekend.
Memorial, whatever it is. Just living at 529 East Branch.
Was it, would it be fair to say at that point in time you and your wife were estranged, that is, not living together?
Yes.
And have you filed for divorce?
Yes.
And is that divorce presently pending in San Luis Obispo County?
Yes.
And do you know who is the person that filed for divorce?
What do you mean?
No, other words, who filed the papers asking for the marriage to be?
Oh, Susan.
And to your knowledge, does she have an attorney?
Yes.
And what is the name of her attorney?
I believe it's Mott.
And are you represented by counsel?
No.
What is the present stage of the divorce or dissolution proceedings as of today?
Still in limbo. I mean, whatever the attorneys do, whatever the, I don't know.
What properties do you own with your wife Susan in San Luis Obispo County? Specifically with respect to the month of May of 1996.
The 710 White Court and 529 East Branch.
Do you have any interest in any other properties in San Luis Obispo County in May of 1996?
No.
To your knowledge, did your wife own any separate property?
No.
At or about May of 1996, other than her interest in these two properties, 710 and 529?
No.
In May of 1996, did you have any interest in properties other than 710 and 529?
No.
In May of 1996, was your wife living with anyone at 529 Brandt Street in Arroyo Grande?
No.
At the present time, is your wife living with anyone at 529 Brandt Street?
Yes.
And the name of the individual with whom she is living is whom?
No, I don't know.
Okay, do you know his first name?
Not the lady there. And something like that.
Your wife then has a roommate at 529, is that correct? Is your wife residing, does your wife have a dating relationship with an individual to your knowledge at this time?
No.
In May of 1996, did your wife have a dating relationship with an individual to your knowledge?
No, don't know.
To your knowledge, since May of 96 to the present date, has your wife been dating any individual on a regular basis?
I don't know.
Do your wife presently has a roommate, is that correct?
Yes.
And that's a person by the name of Ann?
Ann, it's not Ann, it's something else like Ann.
Do you know that person's last name?
No.
Do you know how long that person has resided with your wife at 529?
No, I don't know.
Do you presently live by yourself at 710?
No.
Do you have a roommate?
Yes.
What is the name of your roommate?
Don. Brian. Dale.
So his name is Don Dale?
No, three different names. There's three different individuals.
Okay. So there's Don and Brian and Dale.
Yeah.
These are people that basically sublet from you at the place at 710, is that correct?
Yes.
And what are their last names?
Will they be harassed?
No, they will not be harassed.